Well, the latest stats from the National Hurricane Center keep Sandy right up there. Category 1 winds are still at 75 miles an hour. The difference is here. The storm is beginning to show signs that it's going to go a little bit more north and northeast. And, of course, you can see these bands of rain that are lashing the coast of Virginia and starting to make their way up through the Chesapeake and the Delaware Bays, and a little bit of snow on the left side of the storm. That's what makes this storm so interesting, is that you've got a hurricane on the right side. On the other side, an area of low pressure getting wrapped up in here. The two will tangle and become one, and it's cold enough on this left side of the storm for some snow. And that's an unusual situation, to say the least. We go to Super Doppler 8, and you can see this one particular band of very heavy rain now, just north of Duck, North Carolina, making its way up toward Norfolk, pushing into the lower portions of the Chesapeake Bay. And everything now is starting to progress from east to west into the Susquehanna Valley. These yellow shades here are some moderate to heavy tropical-type rain, just to our south and east at this point, coming across Atlantic City, making its way into Delaware now, not too far from Havre de Grace, being to Philadelphia in a little bit here. At least this band is a little bit farther to the east. And so we've got light to moderate rain around the Susquehanna Valley at this point, but it will get heavier as the night goes on. Winds, not too much to write home about just yet. These are the sustained winds you can see here at home. They're still manageable. It's breezy at times, but they are picking up along the coastal sections. Atlantic City and Ocean City both with sustained winds in the 20s right now, and getting a little gusty as well. As you can see around the region, wind gusts now are starting to poke their nose up into the mid-20s, mid-30s by the time you get down to the shore. We've got the flash flood watch. Went up yesterday, actually. It's going to be up until Tuesday night. And a high wind warning. This had been a watch last night. Now it's a warning. That means you're going to be dealing with some very strong winds out of the storm system. We'll talk about that right now. Heavy rain developing overnight tonight, becoming gusty, 52 to 56. Winds becoming from the north at about 20 to 30 miles per hour. But the strongest winds from the storm likely tomorrow as we get into the midday afternoon evening hours, when we'll be looking at sustained winds of about 35 to 45 miles per hour. We could see gusts up to 70 miles per hour, and we'll have some heavy rain, of course, wind swept rain, horizontal rain to go along with all of that. The afternoon, not much different, with temperatures pretty much locked in there at about 50 to 54, making it feel kind of raw outside, actually. Rain reported now, it's 52. Winds are from the north northwest at 5, and the barometer running pretty low. On the river stages, we're fine right now. Marietta looking at 34.8, 39, Harrisburg, 80, Sunbury. These stages all typical and what we've been seeing. But as we get to the midweek, the forecast from the River Forecast Center shows a very sharp increase in river levels. So not so much at the onset of the storm for the big bodies of water, streams and creeks. Yes, they might flood first, but as we get to midweek and beyond, we'll have to keep an eye on those big streams, namely the Susquehanna River, the Conestoga, Sherman's Creek, Conestoga, etc. So the moisture's coming in right now. The storm center's still well offshore at this point, but it will continue to move a little bit more to the north tonight, it looks like, then start that curve we've been waiting for. This is tomorrow at 8 o'clock. Then as we get into Tuesday, the storm moves over us. Slowly it starts to turn and makes its way off to the north and to the east. So that track is still looking quite persistent, and it looks like that cone continues to shrink, which means certainty is getting higher. Here it is on the predictor for you, and you can see the snow off on the left-hand side of this particular storm system. That is going to be an issue for those folks. Not so much here at home, we don't think, but something we'll definitely keep an eye on. And then as we get this storm to finally move away, well, that's when things will have a chance to start drying out. But as you can see, we keep it really unsettled tomorrow, Tuesday, and Wednesday. Then as we head down the road toward next weekend, we can probably finally wave goodbye to this thing. That's when we'll dry out late in the week into next weekend, and temperatures will remain on the cool side, running below average right across the board there. And of course, there's a lot of questions about, will the snow get here? And that's something we've got to keep an eye on, because there are some blizzard warnings out in West Virginia right now.
You showed me that on the map.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right. Well, sports is next on News 8. News 8's Mike Straub has more. Mike.
Could the Eagles be